Golden Gophers of Minnesota. DTV4 Productions, in association with Raycom Sports, presents Big Ten Basketball. Tonight's game is brought to you in part by Busch Beer, head for the mountains. By your local 76 dealers who invite you to go with the spirit of 76. By Counter Lock and Load Closed Handling System. By Farm Bureau Insurance and the more than 600 Farm Bureau Insurance agents across Indiana. And by Edie's Grand Ice Cream, America's finest premium ice cream made in Indiana with Hoosier pride. We're live from Assembly Hall in Bloomington, Indiana, where tonight the Golden Gophers, coming in with an 8-5 non-conference record, will meet the 9-2 Indiana Hoosiers. Hello, everyone. Chuck Marlowe at courtside with John Laskowski. Well, Laz, coming in here, about 17,000 fans are all tuned up. They're ready to go. It's conference time, and this is where the chips are down.
You can tell it's a different season. Just by talking to some of the fans here, the coaches, everybody's excited about this year's Big Ten season.
Tell us a little bit about Minnesota. What do they bring in tonight?
Well, first of all, they bring in a lot of youth. They're a very young team led by a freshman. There he is, LaShawn Leonard. He's out of Detroit, about 6'4". He's a good shooter. He comes from a great high school program, and he's their young leader this year.
Well, Indiana comes in after a big victory over Cincinnati, 81-60. And what can Indiana fans look for out of their performance tonight?
Indiana's got good play out of Greg Graham in the last two ball games. He's averaged 20 points a game on some very good shooting. He's 49% for the year and 80% from the free throw. Expect him to come off the bench and really give the team a big help.
Okay, now let's take a look at the Napa important parts of the game.
For Indiana, I expect Minnesota to play some zone defense today. They've got to be ready to see that and react to it when the team's in a zone defense. And free throw attempts. Again, Indiana's done a great job of getting to that free throw line. Sometimes the zone defense doesn't let you do that. For Minnesota, their inexperience will hurt them. They have two freshman starters, two sophomores, and one senior, a very young team, and they've been a very good rebounding team. They have yet to be out-rebounded in a ball game. That'll be a key stat to watch.
Give your car the starting power it needs. Get the Napa legend. The best season. We'll be back.
Tied at 41, Eric buries a three from the top of the arc. Then on the very next play, Calvert misses a shot, but Greg Graham gets the rebound, finds Anderson deep in the corner for three more, and IU was on their way to a big-time victory.
The high-energy play of the game from Amex Coal Industries.
Haskins, in his sixth year, brings his Golden Gophers in with an 8-5 record. Overall for Haskins, 81-79 with the Gophers. Okay, we're all set now as we're watching, and our camera is looking right now at the Minnesota Golden Gophers. You see their non-conference records. Let's take a look at the starting lineups, Les.
There you see for Minnesota, Carter is a big, strong forward for him. He's had some problems with some bone spurs, though, and that may hurt him today. Martin's their big center, 7 foot inside. The guards are very quick, McDonald and Leonard. And for Indiana's lineup, we've seen Damon Bailey, a starter in today's ballgame.
Okay, there are the coaches. Clem Haskins, as I said, 6 years for him at Minnesota. Bob Knight in his 21st year with the Hoosiers. And we'll be back with the opening tip-off after these messages.
Why are you drinking so much coffee, Charlie?
Now that Haskins has done it, Minnesota has been a pretty good job in 6 years. If we, you and I were talking before, and he came in his first year, a total rebuilding job and a very, very dismal start as far as his appearance in the Big Ten was concerned. But he's brought them around very slowly. It just seems to be that the balance of how he recruits and what is graduating has not really reached that median yet where he can replace what he loses.
That's exactly right. Real ups and downs. That freshman team from 6 years ago went on to the Final Eight in the NCAA tournament when they were seniors. And you see Bob Knight on the bench for Indiana. And the same thing here. He's got a very young team, two juniors, one senior, and that's it. Everybody else is freshmen and sophomores. So they may take their lumps right now. But Haskins feels that this is a great learning experience for these young players so that when they are juniors and seniors, he's expecting just as good a years as he had with that last bunch.
A big question mark for Minnesota will be the play of their big center, seven-footer, Bob Martin. He's from Apple Valley, Minnesota. There are the officials for the game as Indiana controls the opening tip. Phil Bova, Ted Hillary, and Ted Valentine. We're underway. Our first conference game of the year, Indiana versus Minnesota, as Anderson fakes the shot, gives to Bailey, and off the hands of Chris Reynolds, first turnover of the game.
Minnesota in a man-to-man defense, just as we expected. Damon Bailey getting a start today, seemed a little uneasy on that first possession, tried to get rid of that ball too quickly, unforced turnover.
Indiana, of course, playing its traditional man with the help-out defense, and you've seen that for so many years. It's so commonplace with Indiana fans. Good turnaround, quick shot up to the rim by Walton.
He's a great freshman out of Dallas, Texas, 6'6". And the other freshman that starts besides Leonard, Minnesota likes to go inside on the post if they can.
Back to Anderson, a great give up by Damon Bailey, who suddenly found no room to move, and he hit Eric. Eric comes off a 23-point performance against the Bearcats last Saturday.
Eric has been inconsistent, but that game last Saturday, I think, is a big plus for him, especially with the Big Ten season beginning.
Ariel McDonald. He gives it up to Carter. Carter playing with those bone spurs. Very, very painful feat as McDonald goes off the glass, gets a soft bounce, and hits for two. 4-2 Minnesota early going. And you and I last talked about as Cheney moves down, blocking foul, as Cheney will go up to the basket for, or to the line for two. We're talking that the biggest asset. Watch the replay and then we'll complete that thought.
Right hand dribble to that baseline. We've seen it so many times, so quickly.
The biggest advantage that Minnesota will have is a good start early. Indiana, if they can get off quickly, can pretty well dictate the pace of the game.
Right. For most of these players, one of their first times into Assembly Hall, if Indiana can start this game quickly and get a lead, that'll be a big plus for them. Cheney had a great game against Cincinnati, 17 points, 7 rebounds. So the forward position really got covered by Indiana in that last ball game.
Hoosiers trail 4-3 as Bailey guards the ball coming up. That's Leonard, Vashawn Leonard, a freshman, but he's been the leader for the Golden Gophers. Air ball and a foul on the reach-in goes against Walton as Chris Reynolds turned to bring it up. Second foul against Minnesota, first against Walton.
One of the problems with Minnesota's inside people is they've been up and down. They haven't been consistent. And so it'll be a real key to watch how well they start today, especially Martin, the big player inside.
Anderson with the turnaround won't go. Chase down, tip, but stepping on the line, Cheney. And so the ball is awarded to Minnesota. And we've played 2 minutes, actually a minute and 53 seconds.
Both teams seem a little tired.
Yes.
If you look at Coach Knight's career record, we're sure they played better on non-conference games. Well, I guess that's what happens when you start that Big Ten season. It takes a while to calm down.
Look at the triple over here on the side as Henderson comes down with a loose ball after the block. Over to Anderson. Cheney tries to back in and has it knocked away. It'll be out of bounds, Indiana. Hillary and Bova, the officials on this side, and Ted Hillary making the call. Haskins on his record. To Bailey. Drops it off to Henderson. Two big steps. A little strong in the shot, however, and a foul going over the back will be called on Anderson. Bill Bova said they had the possession. Anderson came over the top.
Anderson couldn't really decide whether to take that in for the layup or stop for the jumper, and that indecisiveness caused that air ball. Anderson reaching over the back for the foul. Indiana not smooth at all in their offense. It's been one pass and a shot. They need to take a little more time, move that ball around, get the good shot.
Watch this young man with the ball, Leonard. Very positive. He knows exactly what he wants to do. A rifle shot that came strong off the front or the leading edge of the rim. Here's Indiana on the transition to Henderson for two.
That's another one-pass shot, but it's a fast break, a little delayed fast break. If you can get an open 15-footer in the right position, that's a good shot. That time Henderson hits it.
And Indiana has the one-point lead, 5-4. Lob inside to Carter and back outside. Good ball motion by the Golden Gophers early, but clock ticking down, 16-15 on the shot clock, and a strong muscle move by Randy Carter for his first field goal.
Indiana's got to prevent that. Minnesota twice now has gotten the inside basket on the post-up, and a foul.
A hand check by McDonald. 6'2 sophomore from Raleigh, North Carolina, picks up his first personal and the team third.
Haskins is a likable guy, and he moves on that bench. He is up and down constantly. Of course, remember at Minnesota, he'll use that towel to kneel down on because the benches are right on the floor.
Henderson tries to follow the big one. Bob Martin, 7-footer, pulls down the board. He had the inside position. And here are the Gophers with a chance to add to their lead. Already up by one. Oh, there's a good cut off the baseline and a great feed to McDonald.
Again, the play's coming inside to Minnesota. Indiana has to double team to prevent an easy shot, and that leaves McDonald wide open.
For three. Henderson has it, or Cheney has it knocked out of his hands. Here's the lead up court. Intimidation by Anderson. The loose ball out of bounds to Indiana. Ted Valentine making the call down there. At the 15:36 mark, we have a timeout, 8-5 Minnesota, and we'll be back after these messages. Ted Hillary may have caught a touch of the flu. He had to come over here in front of the scorer's bench, one of our officials, and Ted is game. He's gonna stay in it. As you look at Ted Valentine, Hillary and Bova over here in front of the bench. That's Phil Bova. And right behind Coach, there's Hillary. I'll tell you something. If you have a little cold and you have to run up and down the floor, worst thing in the world is to have that congestion and try to breathe at the same time, lad.
Right, he looks, his color doesn't look real good either. No. His attitude seems to be pretty good that he wants to stay in there. Let's see, look at the shooting. 4 of 8 for Minnesota. It's 2 of 5 for Indiana.
Bailey tries to dish it off. Carter with the loose ball underneath. Bailey with a great move, but couldn't do anything with it once he got underneath. Leonard. This is Walton. And Martin has it taken right out of his hands by Reynolds. There's a wheeling move as the foul will go against Minnesota.
What a great play by Reynolds as he sneaks up from the baseline to make the steal. Look at this, right there, stripped him, and then quickly gets right down the floor to lead the fast break. As Minnesota turns their back, Reynolds uses that spin dribble, and there's the foul, great quickness.
The second on Jason Walton.
My ball.
Reynolds with 21 steals on the season, a 53% shooter at the line. Jackson in and Walton out for Minnesota.
Dana Jackson, 6'8", 215, a junior. Minnesota will go 10 deep on their bench. They use a lot of players.
Second shot is good by Reynolds. 8-7. Minnesota clings to a one-point lead at the 15-minute mark. 15 minutes remaining, first half. Leonard to the right side. Bashan gives it up to Carter, gets it right back.
He has really helped him from the weak side on Carter.
Inside move, but a foul. Shot was missed. Dana Jackson will be going to the line as Cheney has picked up his first personal.
Cheney's coming from his man on the weak side as he comes over to Coach Knight. And they're double teaming Carter as he gets the ball inside, so he can't go right or left. But they've got Cheney's got to be careful about getting back to his man. Once Carter gives the ball up, that time not quickly enough, and Jackson gets to the line.
Jackson, a 62% shooter, 6'8 junior from Chicago. Averages 7.5 points per game. Misses the second, and the tip comes all the way back out, the board does, to Reynolds. Off to Cheney. Down to Reynolds. Misses the shot. There's Bailey. And he's fouled. Throws it up. Well, that almost went in, but we have a foul. Slap on the back of the net by Cheney. Send Damon to the line.
That's the kind of spirit that this crowd loves to see. Watch Reynolds. Just misses that shot. Bailey comes right in and battles the big center for the ball. He's surrounded by three Gophers. And look at that effort. That's the left hook a la headlock. And out of bounds to Indiana. Ziggy Mazabo, remember him from last year, big 6'9 fella. Comes in to spell Martin.
Yeah, quickly, Reynolds moves. There's a nice driving move by Henderson.
Now there's a big difference. See how Indiana got the ball on the move that time. Much easier to make those shots, even though Henderson had a little semi-hook that time. On the move, much easier to make the shot.
Carter being harassed outside. There's Henderson over to guarding. Look how close Bailey plays Leonard. We have a foul inside.
That's Ziggy Mazabo, and Anderson guarding him in that post. Anderson with good position. And there you see Ziggy Mazabo called on the offensive foul. Let's see if we can pick it up. Watch to the right of your screen right there, 32 and 53. There's the elbow to the side. And the call by Phil Bova. Anderson showing a little emotion there.
Okay, Anderson's out of the lineup. Matt Nober in for Indiana. So it's Nober, Henderson, and Cheney across the front with Greg Graham and Jamal Meeks in the backcourt. Henderson from the side. Yes, sir, it counts. We have a foul.
That's going to be on Cheney inside. Henderson with a great outside shot, pretty well guarded. He's able to get it. But Cheney was fighting for inside rebound position and gets called for the foul. Watch Henderson down. Good pick that time. And right there, you see an elbow flying by Cheney, number 40. And he gets called for the foul.
All right, Graham picks up on Vachon. That's your matchup now. Ziggy Mazabo. Collender in the lineup.
51, Chad Collender, a 6'9 freshman, has really come on strong lately for Minnesota.
Leonard for three. That doesn't go. Over the back, Ziggy Mazabo. Tried to get a hand on the ball, did succeed in doing so, but Indiana comes up with a loose ball. And now the Hoosiers with a two-point lead and a chance to add two more. Henderson, good quick move. Won't go. Out of bounds, Indiana.
Jamal almost catching that five-second call. He gives it right up to Henderson. A little off balance on that shot.
Town, yes, go ahead.
Orr's going to come in for Leonard. Townsend Orr, the young player, 6'1", a sophomore. Dalton, Illinois. We've seen that somewhere before, haven't we, Chuck?
I think we have.
Home of Quinn Buckley.
Meeks. It's all the way back out about 5 feet off midcourt to set. Coming to the ball. There's the cut. Great back cut. He was waiting for it as Greg Grant put a good move on Ariel McDonald.
Jamal picked it up a little too quickly that time. And again, nearly that 5 second call. Grant saw he was in trouble. Makes the nice back cut for the easy layup.
13-9 and a travel. Good pressure by Meeks, who comes up a little gimpy on the far side.
One of Indiana's strengths this year is that speed, that quickness at guard. Jamal got stepped on, taking a few extra steps there, forced a trap right there at the timeline. Nate Tubbs checks in from Fort Wayne. He played a lot for Minnesota last year.
We were told that Haskins would go on to his bench very, very quickly. Three! A high-arching shot by Calvin Cheney for his first field goal.
Indiana making a little run here. That's 8 points in a row. Minnesota had that 9-8 lead.
And Zigamazabo with Nover running him. Orr will fire for three and connect.
Good shooting team Minnesota has, right at the 50% mark for field goals. And there you see some of that from the outside.
Meeks to Cheney. In a half-court offense, a lot of picking, a lot of motion, a lot of screening. That's going to be an illegal pick set by Allen Henderson. His first foul. And we've arrived at the 11:57 mark. Timeout. Indiana with a 4-point lead. We'll be back after these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycom Sports Network. Let's look at that back cut once again. Jamal Meeks to Greg Graham last.
Good recognition here by Graham. He sees Jamal in trouble. Instead of coming out, he makes the back cut. Nobody's under the basket. Turns it into easy 2 points. A good heads-up play by Graham.
11:57 left in the first half of play. Indiana 16-12 following that three-pointer by Townsend Orr, the 6'1 sophomore for the Golden Gophers.
Indiana back on the shooting trail now at 6-12 at 50%, and the rebounding battle so far being won by Indiana.
Orr to Colander, and a whistle, and it goes the other way. This time the foul against Minnesota.
Seems to be calling it pretty close today, Chuck. So a lot of hand fouls, positioning fouls.
That is against Tubbs, and that's the first against Nate, and the seventh against the team. There's Nate from Fort Wayne, went to Wayne High School.
Guards have trouble getting their arms around those big guys. That's why the big guys all huddle up together. This is Indiana from the line. Look at this, 229 attempts made out of 312 attempts, and the opponents have only taken 177. Indiana's more than 40 ahead made than the other team has taken. Amazing stat.
Orr to Tubbs after the missed free throw by Nover. Anderson guarding Zigamazabo. 16-12 if you just joined us. Indiana starting out slow. Zabo to Tubbs. They try to get to the post. There it is again, tipped away. Zigamazabo, however, makes the recovery.
Shot clock down to five. Let's see if Minnesota can get a shot away. I don't know if they realize it.
There's the pressure. No shot. Good, good pressure by Indiana.
That was Tubbs out front. There were 6 seconds to go when he got the ball, but he didn't realize the short time on the clock. And that really brings a praise from the crowd. Five turnovers now for Minnesota.
Interestingly, Meeks came up very, very quickly to front Tubbs and really put pressure on him to keep him from looking up to the clock.
Right, good defensive play there.
Whistle. And the foul goes the other way.
Over inside, trying to set the pick. Second time now Indiana has been called for that. The underneath official really looking for that. That's four turnovers for Indiana.
It appears in the outset that the officials are going to be very conscious of post play. Sure,
seems to be, especially early on, maybe trying to send a message out.
Jackson had a whistle, stops it, and here's a hold. This will go against Indiana. And that brings Bob Knight up to have a few words with Phil Bova. As the foul goes against Nover, his second. That is the 16th foul against Indiana. So Jackson, Dana Jackson, finds his man as Minnesota getting extra life. Jackson, Zigamazabo stripped from his hands and kicked out of bounds off the foot of Cheney. Or I'm sorry, yes, Cheney.
Again, Jamal comes from the outside. He's able to strip the ball, but before Cheney could pick it up, he knocked it out with his foot. Again, the defense is really done well for Indiana. First half nearly 10 minutes old, and Minnesota with only 10 points, 12 points.
The the baseline trap, but they get it back outside, and here's an offensive foul. Zigamzabo picks up his second.
And hear that little murmur running through the crowd here. Again, they realize the number of offensive fouls that have been called. This time it'll end up in free throws as Minnesota's over the limit now. Anderson gets the 1-1.
Bailey checks back in for Indiana. Leonard back in the lineup for Minnesota. Nover sits down with two personal.
Interesting substitution here as Bailey comes in for Nover, giving Indiana three guards, Jamal Meeks, Graham, and Bailey, with Chaney and Anderson left underneath. Minnesota, however, does not have their big lineup in the ballgame right now.
Anderson hits both free throws. Well, Laz, let me ask you a question. With all this focus and emphasis on the post game, what's going to happen? I mean, certainly you can't play a non-physical game in the post.
Seems that the referees are calling that a lot closer, and the player's going to have to adjust. That's why Indiana may have gone with a smaller lineup.
Inside as Graham steps up for two. Inside the three-point line, that is.
Graham has been on fire. He's made 16 of his last 24 field goal attempts and 28 of his last free throws, and he hits his first shot here today.
Townsend Orr guarded by Meeks. Good positioning. Leonard tries to step over and set a pick. It's a good cut. Jackson misses the shot. Anderson clears the board. 9:25 remaining in the first half. To Graham. Oh, that's a big three.
Make that three in a row. He's made all his shots today.
And Graham Haskins wants a timeout. 9:16 left in the first half. 23-12 Indiana. We'll be back after these messages.
With some good defensive play and obviously the great shooting from the outside. Graham hits the shot. Look at the crowd. Look at the team as they come off the floor. Minnesota has to take a timeout to try to regroup. Great emotion right now on the Indiana team.
A lot of the success of that last play to Graham was created by Meeks, who took the ball, started taking the ball back to the center, and then quickly reversed last. And it's this kind of play from the guard that Bob Knight has been looking for.
Well, Indiana started so slowly today from the field, and now look, 57%. Yeah. And out rebounding Minnesota 8-4.
Jason Walton, Leonard for three. That's in the well and out and up. No. Scramble for the ball. Hollander around it. Leonard goes to the glass. Look how hard they crash. And look who's down there scrapping. Here's Meeks. Off Bailey. Behind the back to Henderson. It falls. He's fouled.
What a play. Look at this. Everybody involved with that one trying to go for that rebound. We just talked about the rebounding. Minnesota really stayed on it well. And then Indiana finally comes up and watch. That's Collender right there. Henderson going on the floor. Now Collender's going to throw this. Now it's Walton. He throws it right to Jamal. It's a three-on-one right now. Jamal with the behind-the-back pass. And Henderson gets fouled from behind, but does get the roll. Chance for 3 points.
Rebound off into the hands of McDonald. 8.5 minutes left in the first half. 25-12 Indiana. The Hoosiers have just been on a tear.
Talked about getting a quick jump. The game started pretty even, but now Indiana really stretching that lead.
Knocked away. Here's Meeks again from Henderson. Slows it up. Bailey for three. Yeah!
Boy, Indiana is on fire. That's got to be 5 or 6 shots in a row that Indiana has made.
Graham, and boy, Meeks almost had that one. Anderson guarding Collender.
Defensive pressure still there. Remember how that really hurt Cincinnati. Indiana's on a 12-0 run right now, making their last 6 shots.
On the line, it'll be Indiana ball. Well, that saved And easy, too. There, Indiana will have to work for it now. As Graham was on his way to a dunk.
Clem Haskins really trying to help this team along.
Anderson, and that shot was blocked. We'll go to the line. Jason Walton has picked up personal number three, the 6'6 freshman from Dallas, in foul trouble with 7:35 left in the first half.
Indiana wants three free throws on that, saying he was outside the three-point line. But I believe it's going to be two. And coach asked Ted Valentine, was he on the line? Yes, he was. So only two shots on the foul.
Graham is just showing so much improvement from game to game to game.
He started the first nine games and played some games well and others not so well, but the last, counting this game now, the last three games, Coach Knight's used him off the bench and really has exploded. He's come in today and done, again, a nice job, get some quick points.
All right, here come the Gophers. They're down 29-12. See what they can get going. McDonald, starting a little rotation across the top. Leonard, back to McDonald. Hollander. And Leonard. Leonard will fire for three. Takes a couple of bounces. And jump ball with possession going to the Gophers.
Indiana has really studied this offense of Minnesota's. The defense is really in the positions they need to be to frustrate your offense, and that's why it's been so hard for Minnesota to get that shot away.
See what they try to execute here on the inbounds. Back to McDonald.
Just good pressure outside and then also in the post. There's an air ball.
Martin, and blocked by Jamal, as Martin, who we were told before the game, had to get off to a good start. Now, he probably would not be much of a factor. Wolf in the lineup. Ryan Wolf, another freshman. He's from Martinsville, Indiana. Played with Martinsville last year.
Right, familiar face in this area. Had a great team both his junior and senior year. First pass to him is long. Goes out of bounds for Minnesota's seventh turnover. And it's a pressure defense, Chuck. We saw it against Cincinnati in that second half. Minnesota now with seven turnovers, and Indiana continues that pressure defense and takes teams out of their offense. Here's that zone. Look at Kolander on the top of this 3-2 zone. He's 6'9" and really can cause trouble on that outside shot right there against Jamal.
Anderson underneath the basket on Anderson's shot, but it didn't quite get enough rim, and thus no rebound for the Hoosiers. Up and off the glass, Ariel McDonald, his sixth point. 6.5 minutes, inside 6.5. As we tick down, the end of the first period of play. A feed, but a foul before the shot.
Going to go on Jamal. He really broke through the front line of that zone. But as he did, he couldn't put the brakes on quick enough. This is excellent to penetrate through that zone. But as he does, right there's the contact. He dishes off nicely. But the foul before the dish off.
29-14. Score as Carter goes to the line for the first time tonight. 6'8 sophomore from Memphis, Jamal. Rebound to Bailey. To Henderson, gets it right back. And a hold as Bailey made the penetration right off the top.
It should be difficult against a 3-2 zone to penetrate that middle, but twice now in a row, Indiana's been able to do it. First time a turnover, this time the foul. Reynolds comes in for Meeks, so Bailey will be at the line for the 1-1.
Well, as a lot of that, you said it's difficult to penetrate against a 3-2. You have to credit Indiana's quickness, I think, for a lot of that.
That's what it has been. This will be two free throws because Damon was, Minnesota's had 10 team fouls, and it's two free throws. Indiana still with five players in double figure scoring.
Hoffman with his fourth point. 6 minutes left to play. 30-14 as Indiana has almost made it no contest to this point. Wolf on the line. Right through the hands of Gardner.
Indiana does not match up well right now. Minnesota's got a tall lineup in there. Damon Bailey was guarding Colander, about a 6-inch height difference there.
Bailey. Reynolds. Bailey for three. Oh, that's on line. Boy, that was. We had the picture perfect position on that.
That's what he's in there for. Just move to that open spot. Get ready for that shot. His second three-pointer of the game.
McDonald. There's Graham. There's the help by Anderson. Now the switch. Now Graham gets back. Saved by Indiana. Up to Reynolds. Here come the Hoosiers. Back to Bailey. Bova calls travel.
Yeah, that was a travel. He shuffled his feet. He thought about taking that three-point shot, but Martin was coming out at it pretty fast. And he tried to hurry that dribble. It's called for the travel.
Colander comes out. Tubbs back in. As Minnesota trying to find a combination. They trail 33-14 with 4:55 left to play in the first half. Wolf to Tubbs. The Hoosiers in there right now. Wolf from Martinsville. Tubbs from Fort Wayne. McDonald off the front of the rim. Anderson quick. Chris Graham. Again, looking at this.
Well, back to man-to-man
now.
Yeah,
man-to-man. And a turnaround will send Bailey to the line as Wolf gets his arm. Ryan Wolf called for his first personal.
Played for his father there at Martinsville.
There it is.
Who shot Bob Abel? Ranked team last year for most of the season. Ryan has a good future here at Minnesota, talking to the assistant coaches. Obviously knows the game very well, was around the gym a lot in his younger days, and just needs to get that confidence that every Big Ten player needs to know he can play in the league and get some good time here at Indiana. Damon Bailey, a lot more offensive threat today than he has been. He's trying to create more things. The three-pointers there, again, that time trying to force a little bit of offense, but Damon needs to do that. That's his style of ball.
Minnesota trailing 35-14 as Tubbs gives to Wolf, who will fire and score.
That's why Clem Haskins has his in there. He knows he decided about being back here in Indiana. Makes a tough shot that time.
Eye contact right from the time it came across the line.
Indiana worked on this in practice against that 3-2 zone. That weak side lob pass would be open. That time Henderson saw it. Pass came from the outside.
Dana. Yes, go ahead.
Minnesota only has two field goals in the last 8.5 minutes.
Tubbs, Jackson, partially blocked. Rebound Graham. Come the Hoosiers. And a foul will send Graham to the line. That's on Dana Jackson, his first.
Indiana's got it in full gear right now. The defensive pressure is forcing the turnovers, the bad shots, that end up in quick rebounds, and then Indiana with a number advantage go on the other end on the fast break. And Indiana has really broken this game up from that 10 and 11 point range when it was so close. Indiana just taking over the first half.
Meeks is in for the shooter. That word came from the bench. I don't know whether you could hear it or not, but Bob Knight says for the shooter, so Meeks will be in for Graham.
Indiana's 17th free throw attempt. Minnesota only three.
3:31 left to play first half. Indiana with the lead, 38-16. Back after these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycom Sports Network.
My claim is substitution
Last talk about practicing the alley-oop. You can do that. You still have to have the ball at the right place on the court at the right time.
Martin sees it, but it's too late. The ball's already too high for him to get there. Great timing by Reynolds and Henderson. Probably could have slammed that in there, but just gently laid it over the front.
38-16 with 3.5 minutes left. Look at the shooting.
Indiana on the free throw line, only 10 of 18, but look at the difference in free throws. That's the key figure right there.
McDonald down to Tubbs, turnaround left-handers off the rim, but a foul, and we'll make the long walk to the other end. It's Phil Boba signals against Minnesota. That's against Jackson.
I'll tell you, one thing Henderson does on those rebounds is he goes up for it strong. He's got a good jump, of course, good timing, and he's going to have a lot of fouls like that. Guys are going to have to knock him down to get that rebound away from him. Very impressed with Allen Henderson's rebounding ability.
6'9 freshman from Indianapolis, Britt Buff, with 19 block shots in non-conference play.
Let's watch Henderson right here, 44, watch. Good timing, goes up strong, pulls the ball away from the defense to avoid the slapping of it away, and Jackson commits the foul.
Henderson has an even dozen in his first half effort. We have a lot of alumni organizations watching us, Indiana alumni organizations watching us around the nation. A couple out in California as Wolf takes his shot, no good, tipped away in Anderson control. And a big alumni group watching us down in Houston, Texas tonight. We welcome you. Hope you're enjoying the game via satellite. Over to Henderson, up the glass for two.
Great pass by Bailey, just flicked his right wrist. Henderson right there with the shot. And you're right, 14 first half points. Henderson really lighting him up.
42-16, 2.5 minutes. And Minnesota's gonna be glad to go to the dressing room. Tubbs tries to fight it through, and Bailey shows his disgust, but I don't think the foul, yes, no, it's personal, not on Bailey, it's on me.
Number 23, Jamal Meade.
His second.
His second personal, and he's a substitution.
Substitution, Todd Lineman in the lineup, replacing Anderson. Not too many points for Anderson, only four, but he's played a pretty tough game indeed.
He has, and he's had to play against a bigger team, Minnesota bigger than Indiana coming into this ball game, and a good rebounding team. Indiana has done the job on the boards. Well-deserved rest for that front line.
Nate Tubbs, 60% shooter, misses the first of two. Indiana with 18 fouls first half, so they're still two away from the mandatory two. Look at Tubbs. And he hits the second one for his first point. The Hoosiers will bring it up, contested by some pressure at about three-quarter court. Now Wolf will back away as Reynolds brings it up against McDonald. This is Todd Leary. Back to Leary. To Bailey. Off to Reynolds for three. No, it won't go. Back out to Leary, though. Taking a deep care of him. I think Minnesota's tired. They didn't chase that ball down. Man.
Seems to be they are. Too much up and down the floor. Lindman with the hook shot.
Here's McDonald. And a foul goes against Leary. Came in from the blind side as Dana Jackson turned back into him. Leary commits his first personal.
They do play 10 players, but you're right, Chuck. I still think they are a little tired. Here's a fast break opportunity. It's a two-on-one. Watch Reynolds come up from behind. He helps. Leary tries to make the steal and gets called on the grab right there. Indiana with 19 fouls now, so still a one-and-one for the Gophers.
Jackson misses. Not a good free throw shooting team. Well, they do average 70%, but McDonald and Walton and Leonard comprise probably the best percentage of all. They're at around 82 or 83%.
Called that foul on the shooting foul. That's why I got two shots there.
With a minute 37 left in the first half, Indiana leads 42-18. Hoosiers have the ball. As runs, tries to set it from the top. To Bailey. Oh, that was down in the hole as Martin clears it. Bailey exposed much more to both elements of the game in this first half, Lance.
He's getting more shots at the basket. He needs to do that. It's a big part of his game.
And lost out of bounds as Martin trying to fend off Lindeman. Didn't get to the ball.
Nine turnovers. Even the easy passes are tough. Martin seemed to be wide open there, not really expecting it. As we're in the last minute of the first half.
Bailey, pick set by Nover. Leary from the corner for two. There's about 4 seconds difference between shot clock and the game clock. 44-18 Indiana. Minnesota will try to play for one good shot here to Tubbs. Martin. Blocked by Lindeman. Indiana will have its last effort at the basket. The feed underneath intended for Lindeman. And the passing lane just wasn't there.
Timing was not good. Six turnovers for Indiana. Damon only had 17 seconds left and a half. Probably should have waited for the last shot.
McDonald, Lindeman, big board, 2 seconds. Oh, that came close. What an air ball, and we have come to the end of the first half of play. The score, Indiana 44, Minnesota 18. Tonight's game is
difficult to run their offense, let alone get the shots that they want. And except for that first 7 minutes where the game was pretty close, Indiana has totally dominated the last 14 minutes of that first half. Let's see if Indiana can continue that assault as Calbert Chaney prepares to inbound the ball.
It's going to be Chaney, Bailey, Reynolds, Henderson, and Anderson for Indiana. So Indiana will bring it up. This is Ariel McDonald inside to Henderson, back out to McDonald, on the cut to Chaney, to the glass for two.
Good look by Reynolds. Chaney's moving better without the ball. Reynolds has an eye on him, got him the quick pass. Indiana with two more.
Indiana, Chris Reynolds rather, for Indiana, leading the Hoosier team with 48 assists. There's the errant shot pulled down by Anderson. Across court, three on the way. Nope, that won't go. Boy, if that had dropped, that'd have been a backbreaker, right?
Yes, sure would have. Chaney's really come out offensive-minded in this second half.
Over to McDonald. He lets three fly and score.
Chaney came out to try to set a double team. He couldn't steal the ball, got caught in that no man's land. His man was open, made the shot.
Bailey, he'll go to the glass. He gets a nice little spin roll. He lays it up short on the glass, but gets a spin roll and it just sort of trickles over that rim.
In previous game, he's been hesitating when he gets the ball. Not today. He's really been aggressive. He's trying to get his shot.
And Carter gets a move around Henderson for his first field goal of the second half, but only second field goal in the game. He has only 4 points.
Indiana's taken away the inside game that Minnesota likes to go to, except for that occasion when Carter got it.
Henderson with a turnaround. That hits the side of the board. Here's the outlet. McDonald will drive on Chaney. And Calvert wisely put up a token defense against that shot. Ariel McDonald now with two quick baskets here in the second half. Caught by Bailey. And he can't get the reverse layup to go, but he'll go to the line.
He did a nice job to get that ball on the glass. It just had the wrong spin on it. Actually spun away from the rim instead of toward it. It's moving a lot better without the ball. Here he comes in. Watch this. The ball just was spinning the wrong way. It didn't hit the rim on the way down. But he'll be at the line for the shots.
Alan Henderson out of the lineup as Nover checks back in for Indiana. Bailey readies the first of two. Somebody made a comment. I guess it was just passing conversation the other day about the playing time of players on the Indiana squad. And if you count through the first nine players of Indiana, there's only a difference between of 6 minutes between the player with the most time and the player with the least time.
And that's a great stat because it shows the team balance and minutes played. And that's one reason Indiana's been able to wear some of their opponents down. As I mentioned, late in that first half, it looked like Minnesota was tired.
There's the alley-oop to Martin. That's a pretty good hook up there as Bob Martin gets his first field goal.
Martin starts on the high post, and as the ball swings around, moves down low. Anderson got caught on the high side that time, and the lob pass gets to Martin.
Bailey gets knocked off the court, no call. Reynolds back to Bailey, steps in, will shoot, and just can't get it soft enough off the rim. Technical foul called against the Indiana bench. Ted Valentine makes the call and then stops as Bob Knight had another word or two for him.
It was a two-man game on right in front of the Indiana bench involving Bailey. Bailey got shoved out of bounds. No call was made. And then as he made the drive, he missed the shot, but coach was still on the official Ted Valentine about not calling the force out in the out of bounds. Gives Leonard two free throws.
Leonard's first point. We had mentioned in the first half, he's an 82% shooter, the second best free throw shooter on the Schofield team. Hits the two, and the technical will award the ball to the Gophers on the far side. And Bob Knight is on Ted Hillary now. Hillary seems to be feeling better. He's sort of played off that little illness he had in the first half. Takes it down low, then kicks it back out to Carter. Carter finds Martin over Eric Anderson, and there's just too much height discrepancy between the two.
Right. Minnesota's game plan has changed. They're really forcing that ball to the inside, which is what they should do. Indiana has not prevented that ball from coming inside.
Bailey back out to Anderson. Over to Nover. There's the cut by Bailey, but it was away from Reynolds' view.
Tough pass that time. Looked like it was pretty well guarded. Probably should have waited. Minnesota's made five of their first six shots here.
Into Cheney. Yep. Cheney's shot is short. And it's an easy bound for Jason Walton to Carter. And Leonard. There's Martin. And an easy two for Walton at the other end. So Walton plays both ends of the court well. As Minnesota is finding its way back into this game, trailing now by 17.
Now they're getting pumped up. The players on the bench are on their feet. The offense has come back. And Indiana's struggling at their end.
Here come the Gophers.
Watch your hand. Watch your hand.
McDonald, Leonard, Carter, two.
That's too easy. Indiana's given up that inside position. Minnesota taking advantage of it and really ripping off the points. It's a 15-point ball game right now.
Substitution, Colander, Chad Colander, the freshman from Minnesota. Wanana, Minnesota, in replacing the big fella, Bob Martin.
Indiana needs to take a little more time on offense now. They were scoring well on transition in that first half, but they're having trouble with the half-court offense.
Cheney with the slam dunk. Well, Walton got over there quickly, almost fouled on the slam. Cheney now with eight.
Watch your hand.
It's Indiana's first 2 points in quite some time. And on the drive, offensive foul called out against McDonald. His second. That's the second team personal in this second half. We have a timeout, 15:38 left to play, 52-35 Indiana. We'll be back after these messages. Randy Carter plays the first 20 minutes with only 2 points. We've played 4.5 minutes here in the second half, and he has four more to go with it, Les.
This is how he's dangerous inside. Just a drop step there to the baseline and a soft bank shot. Minnesota 7 out of 8. From the field in the second half, 88%, and they hold a 6-1 rebound edge. There you see the shooting in the second half. and a 6-1 rebounding edge over Indiana. A complete turnaround from the first half stats.
Back to Bailey. Over to Anderson. Great pass. Tipped up. No. Knocked out of bounds. And it's Indiana ball. Last touch by Minnesota. Well, I think Indiana might have gotten a break there. So does Ken Haskell.
Randy Carter doesn't believe it. He thought Cheney had tipped it out. Indiana with the ball out of bounds.
Indiana tries to set it up again. 15 minutes left to play. Bailey, he's had a great game. And offensive foul against Damon Bailey.
He's been creating opportunities for himself and teammates. And this time he's going to get called. Let's watch his left arm. Didn't see it at all there. It looked like Leonard forced the contact there instead of Bailey.
The call goes against Indiana. The outside shot is no good, and the whistle stops the action. And they're going to call that on Leonard as the contact was underneath the basket. And with the Walton and Reynolds.
And also Bailey involved in his block out of his man. Players all over the floor. Indiana needs to get a spark here offensively. Now they see that zone. Look at Colander out in front. It's like a 1-3-1 right now.
Damon comes up short. Here's McDonald. Minnesota finding its way back into this game. And there's two more. Jason Walton.
Somehow Clem Haskins pumped so much enthusiasm and confidence into this team. It's a completely different look in this second half. They're not afraid to take that shot, and the shots are coming easier.
52-37. They already have more than they had in the first half. I'll take that back, just one shot. Anderson.
When you're facing that 1-3-1, that one player underneath the basket can't go on both baselines, so there should be some baseline jumpers open. Anderson that time right in front of the IU bench.
Minnesota. Carter. Down guides from the side. Over it goes to Leonard. Good shot, Bay. And pumps it up. Tipped away by Anderson to Reynolds. Here comes Indiana. 2-on-1 to Cheney. And he's fouled.
It's a good play by Colander. It was a 2-on-1. He hustled down the floor. It'd be his third foul. But he was able to knock that ball away. Watch how Reynolds never looks over. The last second he does. But as Cheney gathers himself, Colander has a second to come back into the play. And foul called against him.
Cheney averaging 14.9 points per game. Interestingly, the 6'6 junior who misses the first has 10 steals in non-conference play. Anderson has 9.
Still having trouble getting that open shot. He was a consistent 20-point-a-game scorer last year. He's down to just over 14 this year, but just hasn't had the scoring opportunities that he had last year.
McDonald, trying to shake off Reynolds. Here's Leonard. No good positions on Carter. He tries the alley-oop and fires a three.
Well, the officials didn't raise their arms to signal that it qualified for a three because they thought it was a pass, as everybody else did. And you know when you smile like that, as Randy Carter is, you know that was a mistake. A lob pass that goes in a basket counts for 3 points.
Go Hoosier!
Here's three attempted at the other end. And the rebound comes out deep. Here's McDonald. An inside move and scores again. And they've got their shooting clothes on now. And Minnesota's back into this game.
What happens is you get down so far at halftime that all you can do is come out and start firing. And when Minnesota did, it started to go in the hoop.
Indiana attacks the inside as Damon Bailey will go to the line on the foul by Colander. His fourth.
And what's happening is Minnesota's got new life. Look at the expressions on the faces there in the huddle. Their confidence is up. They think they can get back in this ball game. They're only 13 points down right now. Let's watch Carter. Watch this. This is a lob pass. He's not watching the rim. He's watching the timing of this leap by Leonard, and it never got there.
Laz, you'd have done that all day, wouldn't you?
I wish it was that easy, Chuck.
Indiana has hit a cold spell, both from the field and the line.
We talked at Cincinnati, Chuck, about the emotions involved in this game, and Indiana was able to overcome that close first half and run away with a victory. And Indiana had it going all its way the first half, and now the emotion is on Minnesota's side. And Indiana's got to regroup here, and they can do it defensively. They got to force Minnesota in some tougher shots and get back control of this game.
Minnesota employs a double high post. And we have a foul against Minnesota.
There's some defense. That's a 5-second closely guarded call. Clem Haskins saying it was only 3 seconds. But that's what we talk about. It's got to be the defense that spurs Indiana on, and that should help the offense.
Greg Graham, Jamal Meeks, as you look at the turnovers. Meeks and Graham, the guards. Bailey back out to Anderson. Greg for three. Nope. And, well, they're getting excellent position. The Hoosiers have no rebounding position at all. Indiana ball, Phil Bova changes his call.
Well, Jason Walton got in front of the crowd that time. A lob pass just off his hands, or an easy layup for Minnesota.
And a block as Graham turned on the afterburner, trying to get around Jason Walton. Walton now has picked up his fourth foul.
Fouls are going to be a big part of this second half. Minnesota with 6 already. Indiana just with 1.
11:59 left to play in this game. Indiana leading 56-42. We'll be back after these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycon Sports Network. Laz, even the cameraman getting the line of fire.
Yeah, watch this. This is the underneath camera. Greg Graham's making the drive, and boom, the official bangs into the cameraman as he emphasizes that charge. As they say, Chuck, that's life in the Big Ten.
Indiana with the ball and the lead, a 14-point lead, 56-42.
Shooting by Minnesota, 77%. The second half.
Cheney. Good turnaround right in front of Nate Tubbs. Tubbs had Cheney, as Indiana had Cheney posted. And Calvert just a little bit too much on that. McDonald cross court to Orr. A call. He's wanted to travel.
Indiana protecting that inside now.
Zigamuzalo. Or from the side. And the rebound to Meeks as Anderson came over to cover as well. Here's Graham. Cheney with a good move. Up for two. Yes.
There you go. On the defensive end, they force the outside shot. On the offensive end, they get it to their big score, and he drives the baseline for a jumper.
McDonald. Zigamuzalo almost ran into that pass to McDonald. Here's Jackson. Jackson has not been a factor. He only has 2 points. Left-handed shot up by Tubbs, and the rebound to Anderson, out to Meeks, who slows it up. Anderson for three. Oh.
Big play there by Anderson. 5 points in a row. Stretched his lead back to 21.
63-42. We'll see Randy Carter again for Minnesota at the next dead ball. Near steal by Meeks. He does get a hand on it. And a reach-in foul called against Minnesota. That's just extra effort. Townsend Orr comes up with a personal on superb effort by Jamal Meeks.
Right. The first time he didn't get it, he stayed after it. Finally came up with a lot of substitutions now for Minnesota.
Now they go back to their original lineup to start the second half. Leonard, well, Tubbs is in there now. Carter is back in. Colander also in the lineup. limit already as Jamal Meeks hits for his first point.
Indiana's made its last four field goal attempts. And as Minnesota started to get back in this ball game, got it down to 13 points, Indiana has responded to get that lead back up to 23.
Meeks improves on his 79% average from the line, hitting both 65-42. Carter. I tell you, you have to give that young man a lot of credit. He's playing with those bone spurs. Both feet. Boy, that is just two. We'll give that to Orr. Townsend Orr on the line when he shot. But back to Carter again. You know, playing with that kind of pain in your feet. Anderson for his 11th point. Minnesota staying pretty much in a game plan, Lance. They're not becoming undisciplined.
Well, there you see, that's what they like to do. Go right inside to Carter.
Jump ball. It'll go to Minnesota, but it's good effort by Eric Anderson.
Well, that's a great play by Anderson because Minnesota's been so successful with getting that ball into Carter. He spins to the hoop and gets two. Now this time Anderson's able to stop him. Good position there, and the jump ball is called.
5 minutes. Check that, 9 minutes, 22 seconds. Colander. Nope. Rebound to Bailey. Colander goes down. Bailey gives it up to Meeks. Gets it back. Over to Anderson for the stop.
That's a great fast break. Now Indiana's got control of the ball game.
There's the alley-oop. That worked that time. Boy, Colander.
It's a good set play. Yep. The ball comes in. A high post pick on the guard. By the time the defender realizes he should be switching, the pass is already in the air at the basket.
Taken away as Graham is stripped of the ball. Here comes Orr. He had that last basket on the receiving end. There's a block on Jamal Meeks. His third foul.
Jamal not quite set that time. Minnesota's got to play an up-tempo game now to get back in. 8:31 left. Jamal picks up his third.
Colander blocked by Anderson and comes away with a ball. That's playing it all.
Anderson defensively has really made a difference here to keep Minnesota from coming back in this game.
Bailey for three. It goes. We have a foul. That foul goes against Cheney. Paul Calvert for the foul. Working for post position underneath. But
trying to get the rebound. Let's see if we can pick it up. Look at the left part of the screen. The foul was called just as the ball approached the basket. The bucket does count, but Cheney picks up the foul.
Orr lets three fly, and Anderson clears for Indiana. 7:56 left to play. Hoosiers 72-46, and a whistle.
Well, one thing about this Indiana team, they are an explosive offensive team. That lead was just 13 points about 5 or 6 minutes ago. And now Indiana's close to making it a 30-point game.
Walton checks back in. Jason in for Orr. Townsend Orr sits down with 7 points. One of them that alley-oop from Randy Carter.
At the line is number 40, Calvert Cheney.
And Calvert Cheney, the junior from Evansville, played his prep ball at Harrison High, steps to the line with 13.
79% shooter coming in the ball game. He's missed two. Still a good afternoon or good evening of scoring for Calvert. But what's happened, Indiana's defense has really keyed their offense. When they've been able to stop Minnesota at the other end, it's led to offensive points.
7:52 left to play. Indiana with the commanding lead, 74-46. And we'll be back after these messages.
Anderson's there for the jam. Great teamwork. Anderson leaves the game, 13 points, two block shots, and some pretty good defense against a good inside player for Minnesota.
Leonard just comes right behind two Indiana players, right through them, rather.
Minnesota shooting terrifically here in the second half, but still Indiana keeping that 28-point lead.
Over the back, there's going to be a foul, sends Indiana down to the other end to shoot again. That foul was on Leonard, and I have him for three all in the second half.
Good sign here for Indiana. Remember back to the Kentucky game. It was a close game all the way, but at the end of the game, Indiana made some plays that really weren't smart, and Kentucky was able to win that ball game. They control the first half. Minnesota comes out and does a nice job of trying to get themselves back in the ball game, cutting that lead down drastically. Indiana regroups at a timeout, come back, and really extend this thing out now, where they should be able to hold on. Still 7:36 left in the game.
You know, one of Indiana's strongest suits is its ability of its guards to play low on defensive rebounds, Laz. And a whistle that will go against Indiana as Allen Henderson just a little bit too aggressive for that rebound. His second foul.
A lot of times the big guys have enough trouble blocking out to keep their men from getting the ball, and that ball can be tapped more often than not, and the guards have to be in a position to get it. Indiana's guards do a nice job of that to make sure the other team doesn't come up with those loose balls.
Carter, nice to get it out of trouble. And inside, a whistle, and that's going to be an offensive foul. A push-off will go against Tubbs as he tried to get position on the lob pass. Third foul against Tubbs. So down to the other end we go. Bailey comes out. Great game.
Tried to shield off Reynolds from stealing that ball. A lot of offensive calls. It was a good game for Damon Bailey today. He played well against Indiana State. Only got 2 points at Cincinnati. Comes back today with 17 points. And some good leadership out there.
Matt Nover replaces Bailey. Chris Reynolds has hit for the 76th point for Indiana. With that basket, time for the 76-point reminder. After the game, stop by your neighborhood 76 station for quality 76 gasolines or convenience items. Tubbs, Leonard for three. Henderson times the jump, gets a jump ball, it'll be Indiana ball.
He actually mistimed that a little bit as he went up too quickly and the ball came down, but yet he still had the presence of mind to reach in there for the tie-up, and Indiana gets it on the change of possession.
Reynolds up against Leonard. Almost lost it, and then gives it up. Cheney backs it out. 6:40 left to play. Henderson, soft pull up for two. This kid's really playing well. 16, that's his first two in the second half.
He's really come along quickly. It'll be a big help in this Big Ten season. Good block there by Reynolds.
Look how quick the hands are, though. That ball was going like a dart. As Walton tries to split Indiana and draws the foul.
Watch Reynolds, he's coming from behind. Quick, it blocks that shot. Leonard doesn't quite know what happened. Good defense.
Lindemann is in the lineup replacing Jamal Meeks or Calvert Cheney. Let's check to see. Meeks is out, Cheney is out. Lindemann is in, so is Todd Leary. So Indiana going with a lineup now of Lindemann, Nover, Henderson, Leary, and Chris Reynolds. 6 minutes, 19 seconds left. At the line is Jason Walt. Pretty good free throw shooter, but misses this one. Well, Indiana will practice early tomorrow. This still being between semesters here on the campus, and then they will board a plane for Madison, Wisconsin, where they will meet the Badgers. No basket.
The free throw went in, but Martin stepped across the free throw line before the ball reached the rim. and it's a violation.
So scratch that last free throw of Jason Walton. And Indiana still 79-46. The Wisconsin Badgers next on the agenda for Indiana. 5 o'clock Saturday afternoon. Nover behind the screen. Two.
I see the offense is picked back up again. Early in the half, Indiana had some trouble scoring. Right now, again, we're seeing that potent offense. Another game, Indiana scoring more than 80 points.
It goes to Carter for three.
He's better off passing it from there.
Yes, I think so.
The pass he makes from there goes in. The jump shot, he can't hit.
Well, that was almost an impossible pass that Chris Reynolds tried to make that time underneath. So once again, the Gophers get an opportunity. And of course, following next Saturday's game against Wisconsin, Indiana has to come back and prepare for a highly regarded Ohio State. And a whistle against Leary, his second.
Carter just didn't seem to be as aggressive in the first half. Fighting for that post position that he is now, a change that was made at halftime. McDonald and Wolf come back in the ball game at the guards positions, but you can see how dangerous Carter is inside when he's allowed to post up. He's too strong in there to stop once he gets the ball.
I'll give Carter two free throws, fouled in the act of shooting. Carter with very little trajectory on the shot, 65% shooting from the line. And this one also right on target for his 11th point. 81-48, 5:14 left to play. Henderson.
Did a great job to regroup himself. Seemed like he was off balance, but yet he still got that nice soft jumper in.
Walton. Wolf.
Martin.
I think that was a pass. Who's in there for that board? Here's Reynolds. Oh, he kicks it out quickly. Over to Leary for three. Leary gets his rebound. Back over to Henderson. And then Leary with a loose ball. Henderson. And right through the hands of Lindemann. I think Todd was ready for that pass.
No, he wasn't, and you've got to be. Allen didn't want to make that travel. Paused in the lane. Lindemann's got to have those hands ready, knowing a pass could come at any time.
Nober with an over-the-shoulder steal. It's just great hustle by the young junior from Chester. Going to go. There's a push-off that will send Indiana to the line. Matt Nober to take the free throws, and the foul is on Carter. It's only his second. Now the 6'8 sophomore from Memphis will come out. He'll take a breather, and he gets a handshake from his coach.
Well, next one, much better second half is the reason for that.
11 points for Carter.
Mentioned about Minnesota's rebounding prowess. They have not been out-rebounded in any game this year. In fact, on about a 42-35 advantage. Indiana today, though, has a 33-23 edge in the boards. Another strong point for Indiana this year has been the rebound.
3:59 left to play, 84-48 Indiana. We'll be back after these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycom Sports Network. Here's your score and the time remaining. 17,238 fans on hand for this first Big Ten game of the season. Some begin to leave for the exits. Tipped up, Henderson with the loose ball. Here comes Indiana. Nover, and he'll go back to the line on the foul.
Goes to the basket strong that time. Good control on the dribble. He was switching there to the left hand. Martin makes the foul.
Indiana is really showing the threat in a lot of ways, Laz, that all five players are going to have to be defensed out there all the time.
They are a multi-dimensional offensive team. That's exactly what the coaching staff likes. That's why you've got five players in double figures. You've already talked about the equal amount of playing time
that the players are getting. Matt having trouble from that foul line today.
He's the best free throw shooter on the team, 84%, but that worked in a bit after a couple of misses. He has just 4 points. Colander back to Walton, a whistle, and it's jammed up inside. Foul will go against Indiana. And Lindemann has picked up his first.
Both players are at the same height. A little unusual for a big guy to see another guy his size, but it's been a good matchup with Martin and Lindemann. Let's watch.
Make sure the ball's out.
Martin's kind of backing up. He had good position on Lindemann. Todd with the foul.
And a foul. Ted Valentine very quick to make that call against Leary, his third. That puts Indiana over the limit, 1-1. Actually, there are 8 fouls. Zabel is back in, replacing Martin.
As Coach Knight, he's seen his team with 2 great runs. You'd mentioned that first in the first half. Indiana now on a 30-6 run in the last 8 minutes here in the second half.
Colander averaging 6.5 points a game. That's point number one tonight. 85-49, 85-50, with 3:24 left to play. The Hoosiers go deep into their bench relentlessly. There's a foul. Now Leary gave the ball up on a steal and then comes back and takes a foul from Ariel McDonald. Let's look again.
It's good quick hands here, but watch how Leary stays after it. He's really got inside position here. And then the undercut by McDonald puts Leary on the line.
Donald's third foul. He goes out. Back in is Townsend Orr. Just a sophomore by eligibility out of Lawrence North. He redshirted 1 season and gets this one to fall as well. So he has 4. And the only player not to score for Indiana is Todd Lindemann. 87-50 Hoosiers as we near the 3-minute mark. Just to lob it inside. There goes Zygmunt Szabo with the turnaround. Big board by Matt Nover out to Leary. Here they come. And an offensive foul.
Townsend Orr with some good quickness right there. Reynolds, probably the quickest player on Indiana's team. He had the ball on that left-hand dribble. And the call goes against Indiana.
First foul on Reynolds. With the exception of that one little spurt, Laz, and not to put this down too much, you've had to watch this game strictly, if you're an Indiana fan, from the defensive aspect, because otherwise it hasn't been too much of a game. And it's been hard played, of course, by both teams at both ends, but Indiana has held a decided offensive advantage. And a foul. It's going to go against Jason Walton, and Walton has fouled out. 2:20. Remaining, Walton sits down now with 6 points in the game. That's, not to take anything away from this contest, but Indiana had amassed this 44-18 lead at halftime on that great run of 33-9. And they did that largely through defensive pressure.
Right, that's been the key. The defense has come through to spur the offense. Robert Rowe, 6'7" sophomore out of Fort Worth, Texas, checks in. And that is what has enabled Indiana to get as many points as they have.
If you're going to just exchange baskets, it's very difficult to get these 80, 90-point games Indiana's had. You've got to stop them on the defensive end and then convert that to offense, give you a lot of opportunities at the offensive end.
So fresh, yes, go ahead.
Very well-rounded play for Indiana.
The freshman from Channing, Michigan hits both free throws. Pretty good free throw shooter for a 7-footer. Or takes it left side. 3 on the way. That won't go. Henderson clears it out to Leary. Henderson steps up to the glass. Misses. Rebound to the Golden Gophers. Here they come. Town Sonora with a minute 49. Gives it up, and there's the steal. Leary for three.
Yes! He likes that three-point shot. You see how he gets his feet set. Even on the fast break, he wants that ball to take that shot.
92-50, a 42-point advantage as we near the one-minute mark. Rowe has not seen a lot of action this year. Wolf. And a big board for the seven-footer. Turnaround by Leary. Good!
The other thing, Chuck, all the players on this team can score. You give a guy an open shot for Indiana, and he's going to make it. Right from Calvert-Cheney all the way down the line.
49 seconds left to play. Four. Locked. Henderson. Up to Reynolds. They want Leary to shoot two more. Lindemann. Ah, that's not going to go. That's a good turnaround. They're trying to work him off the post, get him to use the hook for that baseline move. I think by the time he's a junior, he'll be a pretty good ball player. 19 seconds left to play. Wolf. And Leary with an easy board. 10 seconds. Turnover. Tipped up by Henderson.
Left-handed tip that time. He snuck through as the game ends.
We have come to the end of regulation. And it's an Indiana victory. They go to 10-2 in the season, 1-0 in conference play. The final score, Indiana 96, Minnesota 50. We'll be back after these messages.